Well, over the past 6 months, Richmond police have been following tips and leads in the disappearance of Savannah Spurlock. And it was a tip by suspect David Sparks' father that led to the discovery of Savannah's body. Jacqueline Nye has the latest in the investigation. It's the LAX-AT Big Story at 11.
Savannah's mother, Ellen Spurlock, has always tried to remain hopeful that maybe someday she would see her daughter again.
There is that possibility that she is okay and she will come home to us.
And while that shred of hope of a happy reunion has slowly been pulled away in the over 6 months since her disappearance, yesterday's discovery of Savannah's remains confirmed Ellen's worst fear, a reality she began to confess less than a month ago in an interview with us.
It's just not looking good. The way I look at it is if she isn't here, she's looking down on us in a better place in heaven. And she can see that we're taking care of her kids.
Both of Savannah's parents have been outspoken about the possible involvement of the three men she was last seen leaving a Lexington bar with. An interview I did with Savannah's father less than 2 months ago, he held true to that belief.
Somebody knows something. Somebody, they can't. They'll mess up sooner or later. We'll find out what happened to her. I know it. I know we will.
23-year-old Savannah leaves behind four young children. Her twins were just 6 weeks old when she disappeared. Today, her aunt took to Facebook to announce they will be closing Savannah's missing persons page as they now wait for justice.
As KSP now takes the reins, we pray that justice will be served by anyone involved.
Eleanor Buckley, LAX 18 News.
Well, in court, Sparks entered a not guilty plea to the charges against him. He was handcuffed and guarded closely by two deputies. Savannah Spurlock's family has been living in agony with no answers on her whereabouts. While yesterday's news of the discovery of her remains brings closure, it also leaves a void in the hearts. They knew this outcome was possible, but hope for a miracle. Jacqueline Nye has reaction.
In January, Savannah Spurlock was seen on surveillance video leaving the other bar in Lexington with three men. Police say one of those men, David Sparks, was a primary suspect, but maintained his innocence even though Savannah was seen at his house that same night. In February, investigators searched the home on Follick Road, but nothing came of it. And then yesterday, a break in the case. According to an arrest citation, David Sparks' father noticed a foul odor coming from the back of his property and then contacted an attorney. This tip led state police, Garrett County Police, along with the FBI, to spend several hours investigating the Follick Road property, focusing on an area behind the home where human remains were found.
As a result of the autopsy, we can now confirm that the remains are those of Savannah Spurlock.
The citation states Savannah's body was discovered concealed in an unnatural position along with some of her belongings. During last night's search, we watched as investigators collected evidence bags in a box. Investigators say it's too early in their investigation to know how long her body has been there, but her body was not put there recently. After executing the search warrant overnight, state police arrested and charged David Sparks with abuse of a corpse and tampering with physical evidence.
Detectives are going to continue to follow up on tips, leads, interview people to try to determine and paint a better picture about what may have actually happened.
The other two men seen in the video with Savannah have been interviewed, but neither charged. Investigators are waiting on a cause of death from the autopsy before they rule out if any more charges will be filed. In Madison County, Jacqueline Nye, LAX 18 News.